Hi, I'm Manoj Reddy, a customer engineer in the Identity and Authentication Engineering team at Microsoft. In this video, we'll look at how to perform a basic configuration and health check of the NPS extension manually. We will also look at event logs of NPS, NPS extension, and some common errors you might see while working with NPS extension. Default MFA method used by the user plays an important role in the functioning of NPS extension. There are two factors that affect which authentication methods are supported by your NPS extension deployment. The first one is the password encryption algorithm used between the RADIUS client and the NPS service. If you use PAP, it supports all the authentication methods of Azure AD. If you use CHAP V2 and EAP, phone call and mobile app notification are the only supported methods. The second factor that controls the authentication methods is the client and the input methods the client supports. For example, does the VPN client have some means to allow the user to type in a verification code from a text or a mobile app? If it doesn't, then push notification and phone call will be the only supported methods. During the installation of NPS extension, a pair of registry keys are created and they control the functioning of NPS extension. While troubleshooting or while performing a health check, we should always check the registry keys and ensure they have the correct values as shown in the screen. Post installation, you can find the config details of the NPS extension stored in a registry key called Azure MFA as shown here. Tenant ID and the client cert identifier are the most important values in the configuration. You need to ensure the tenant ID and the cert data matches the tenant the user belongs to. At the time of installation, the configuration script creates a self-signed certificate valid for 2 years and it's stored in the personal store of the local machine. The configuration script also associates the public key of the certificate to the Azure MFA Auth Client Service Principal in Azure AD. You can verify that the client certificate linked to the SPN matches the cert on the NPS extension by running the PowerShell command displayed on the screen. The command will download the certificate from Azure AD and you can validate it against the certificate in the personal store by matching the thumbprint property in details. For basic troubleshooting, we can use the event logs of NPS and NPS extension. NPS event logs can be viewed using Event Viewer under Server Roles NPS section. Event ID 6272 indicates a successful login event for NPS, and you will see details about the user, client, connection request policy, and network policy in this event. 6273 and 6274 indicate a failure, and you will find a clue towards the cause in the logging details section of the event. NPS extension logs can be found under Application and Service Logs, Microsoft Azure MFA section. You will see logs for authentication and authorization. The operational logs in Auth Z section will give you detailed errors regarding the cause of the issue, and the events are pretty self-explanatory towards the cause. Some of the common errors you will find in the NPS extension event logs are listed in this public document, along with the troubleshooting steps that you can take to resolve them. You can find the link for this document in the description of the video. You can find the MFA logs for the user in Azure portal as well. Within the sign-in logs blade, apply the resource ID filter for the value RADIUS to see the logs of NPS extension. Under the basic info tab, you will see the details about the user, tenant ID, correlation ID, etc. Under the authentication details section, you will find the MFA method utilized by the user. I hope this video helps you in troubleshooting NPS extension. Thank you.